Hey guys, what's up? We're having a look at this, the 2020 Toyota RAV4. This one happens to be the TRD off-road model. If you're a fan of the channel, you know I love driving fast, fun things. And this is not exactly fast. So why am I having a look at this RAV4? Well, there's one good reason. In my line of work, if you will, people always ask about car purchases and what should I buy. So when someone is asking me about a midsize crossover, I've got a very short list. And that includes the CRV, which we recently looked at. The RAV4, like the CRV, is on my short list. And it's, you know, it's really a simple solution for people who are not, you know, car people and looking for a midsize crossover. And, you know, this is something that actually works for a lot of people. Anyway, let's get into this and have a look at this 2020 Toyota RAV4 TRD off-road. The RAV4 is actually available in a bunch of flavors. Unlike most of the cars or crossovers in the competitive set, there are a ton of variations to the RAV4. You can get it in front-wheel drive, you can get it in all-wheel drive, you can get it as a hybrid. And this one is basically at the top of the range. It is the TRD off-road model, so it's got the different suspension, different tires, different wheels, and a few other trim pieces. What is coming and what you should be aware of is later in 2020 for the 2021 model year, I believe, the RAV4 Prime, which is a plug-in hybrid, and with the 2.5-liter gasoline motor combined with the electric motor, it's going to make 300 horsepower. Promises 0 to 60 times in under 6 seconds, whereas this one is about an 8 second 0 to 60, so you're going to be able to get a very, very quick RAV4. And this TRD off-road model is not quite badge engineered, and it's not quite a full-out factory special. It's somewhere in between. In this configuration, it's something that I would take off-roading, or at least some of the light off-roading that I've done recently, and I wouldn't have any problem with it, and that's because it does work as an off-roader. There is no change in ride height, but what Toyota has done is developed a specific tire with Falcon, and it is off-road. Funny thing is, though, it's rated for snow service, and here in Canada, where I am right now, Toyota's put on a winter tire. I would have actually liked to have tried that Falcon, because it is bespoke to the TRD off-road RAV4. You also get these distinctive 18-inch wheels. They look great, and you know, they fit the rest of the look of this RAV4. Most importantly, there is some tricks. So there are some tricks going on with the suspension. As you can see, there are red springs. I've done a lot of digging. I don't think there's a spring rate change at all, but what they have done is completely redone the dampers. You've got different bump stops in there so that this thing can handle off-roading. And I also believe the shocks have been revalved, and there is an additional internal spring to help full extension or full compression. It's a light effort, and this is a crossover. It's not a hardcore off-roader, but this is something I wouldn't have any difficulty taking over that mountain range where I took the ZR2 Bison. You've got the different off-road drive modes and a hill descent control, and I don't know what the names are in Toyota speak, but I have tried them. It all works wonderfully. However, with respect to different drive modes, the off-road modes are mud and sand and rock and dirt. In terms of regular drive modes, there's eco, normal, and sport. And what I'm finding is I'm hitting sport. There's actually not much difference between any of the drive modes. It all kind of drives the same. And that's partly because this is a naturally aspirated engine that doesn't make a lot of torque until higher up in the rev range. And you know, with a turbo motor, as most of the competitors have, you can easily manipulate that with different throttle map. But here, there's not much difference between any of the drive modes. So what I'm finding, again, is I hit sport and I hit the automatic hold button, and which I haven't done yet on this drive. So here I am stopped at a light, and I'm able to take my foot off the brake pedal. Love this function, absolutely love this function, especially because I live in a city. However, the challenge is, just like CRV, you've got to press the button every single time you get in the car. And I can appreciate that it shouldn't be on all the time. Other manufacturers do it, and I like that function. Only problem is, when you're parking in certain situations, the brakes will stick, and it's not as easy to maneuver. So I get that, but I do like that function, and I'm glad it's here. What I do like about the interior design is that everything is laid out very straightforward, and in general, it's relatively attractive and inoffensive. You've got a big screen sprouting from the top of the dash. With respect to the infotainment system, not as bad as what you'd find in the Honda CR-V, but still not great. It is redeemed, of course, by Apple CarPlay, and I think you can get Android Auto, but I'm not an Android user, so I really don't care. As you know, I'm always concerned about how things drive. Seating position is quite good. At least there's a plenty of adjustment with this driver's seat and the steering column. Of course, visibility is excellent. It is crossover, and Toyota knows how to do that. No complaints there. With respect to dynamics, first you need to understand that this is powered by a 2.5-liter four-cylinder. It makes 203 horsepower, 184 pounds of torque, and that's, you know, more than adequate. I think what makes the drivetrain, however, is this automatic. It was developed by Toyota a couple years ago. They've ensured that it shifts very quickly and rapidly, and that's what I love about it. What I don't like about it is, of course, the manual control are the wrong way. So push forward for up and pull back for down. It just doesn't make any sense. It's counterintuitive. Toyota says the all-wheel drive system is the torque vectoring kind. And of course, with modern control systems, that's something you can do. I simply didn't have the opportunity to drive it on any low grip surfaces, but it sounds very cool. And I believe it also disconnects for fuel consumption. And with respect to fuel consumption, I've been averaging in mixed driving 24 miles per gallon. I've driven about 400 miles in mixed city and highway driving. And I will say, ride is exceptionally comfortable. Steering is fine. You don't get a lot of feel. Of course, it is an electrically assisted-based system. Not a lot of feel through the steering wheel, as you'd expect, but it is precise and direct. Also, dynamically, what I do love about this is brake feel. Brake feel is excellent. Control is excellent. And Toyota's done a fantastic job tuning the brake pedal, the brake system in this RAV4. It gives you a lot of confidence. Given that this TRD off-road RAV4 is really geared towards, you know, somebody who does enjoy the outdoors, they've done the right thing, and they've ensured that this will tow up to 3,500 pounds. And that's meaningful. You know, that's a couple of Sea-Doos, that's a small boat, a couple of motorcycles. There's lots of room in the second row in case you do have a young family. There's plenty of room back there, and there's plenty of cargo capacity under the boot. Now, why do I recommend the RAV4? Well, for three key reasons. One, it's a Toyota and it is known to be safe. And if you've got a young family, you want your vehicle to be safe. Number two, it is reliable. Toyota and reliability go together like peas and carrots. And number three, it retains its value relatively well, as most Toyotas do. So for those three reasons, that's why I recommend the RAV4. And do I recommend this particular RAV4? Well, I think you'd have to be a particular kind of driver. You'd have to really be an outdoors kind of person. And like I was saying, this TRD off-road is at the top of the RAV4 range, so it is a bit spendy. It has all the content that you could possibly desire. You've got to spend a good chunk of change, about 36,000 US or 43 Canadian will get you into one of these. It's at the top of the range, but it will go off-roading a little bit better than the regular RAV4. It probably looks the best out of all RAV4s. I think the only other compelling option for me is when that RAV4 Prime arrives, just because it's got 100 more horsepower. I really like the way this drives. A middle of the road crossover, it does all the things I want it to do. Getting up to highway speed, no problem at all. Thankfully, we've got a long on ramp, and you know, here we are. Highway speeds, very comfortable. All things considered, you really can't go wrong with the Toyota RAV4. Again, it falls on my short list with the CR-V, and to me, it all depends on your personal preference. But you know, these two vehicles are really on that short list for me, and the ones I recommend to anybody who asks, who's not a car enthusiast like us. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2020 Toyota RAV4 TRD off-road. Hope you liked this piece. If you did, well, if you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. If you're going to subscribe, well, do subscribe. Turn your notifications on. We've got episodes dropping Wednesdays and Sundays. Sundays are the cool things. Wednesdays are things like this. you have any questions or comments, we'll leave them in the comments below. And if there's anything I didn't get to, please do leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, well, please share this on your social, and especially Reddit. That helps us out a lot. And if you do want to support the channel, well, hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of cool stuff there, and it will save you a trip to the mall. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time.